was hit with 167 steel jacketed bullets, fired from high powered rifles in the hands of police officers.
Many of the bullets passed entirely through the door on Clyde's side, through Clyde's body, struck Bonnie, passed through her body, then out through the door on her side of the car.
Any one of those rounds would have been fatal to both. But having killed 14 people, many of whom were officers of the law, and having come safely through so many gun battles, it did not seem advisable to fire just one bullet.
Even in the final moment, I pray that somehow, by some miracle, Bonnie would walk away unharmed. But at 23 and 25 years of age, Bonnie and Clyde died as they lived, on the road and by the gun.
Sunday clothes on a Tuesday. Chestnut Barrow. You have been found guilty on one count of burglary and two counts of auto theft. You are both hereby sentenced to 2 years at the McLennan County Jail.
High school, we were there. Maybe you remember him.
I don't think so.
Well, I thought maybe you'd like to go.
Oh, sure. Are they going to have a band?
Oh, yeah, I'm pretty sure there's going to be a whole band.
Oh, kid, sheriff's on the phone.
All right. Oh, can I take the. Thanks. Now, hang on, I'll pick you up on Saturday at 7.
The whole band.
It must be great to be called the It Girl. That isn't what they're calling me, but when they sing, I bet you they will. Oh, damn it! Damn it! Damn it!
Hey! Engine trouble?
Damn car goes through oil like a preacher through whiskey.
Well, how about I see if I can fix you up? Maybe you give me a lift into West Dallas?
Well, sure. Thanks. So you live in the Dale's back porch?
Not for much longer.
Oh, I don't know anybody ever moved out of West Dallas.
Well, you do now. Clyde Barrow.
Bonnie Parker.
You got a beautiful smile. But you hear that all the time.
Why, yes, I do.
Me too.
So where are you moving to?
Anywhere I want. Just like the legendary Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid? He was an outlaw.
Why, yes, he was.
But wasn't Billy the Kid ambushed and killed by some sheriff?
He wasn't ambushed. He died an old man in the arms of a young woman.
I'm pretty sure he was gunned down.
Well, I'm telling
in
you.
In some hotel room.
It don't even matter. I got plans.
Everybody got plans.
Everybody got dreams. I got plans.
The men in this town live and die and are forgotten. And it doesn't seem to scare them. I can't wait to get away. Away from the drought and the homeless and the hungry. When they talk about foreclosures every hot and dusty day. I don't intend to waste my life around here. I got it all mapped out. Lost that X-State apron and wore something. from a madman at the store. Yes, I can see you in a car with your own driver. You're headed for your penthouse that will overlook the shore. Your face should be up on that silver screen. You've got that it, girl, look.
Trouble.
And yet you seem to have no trouble finding it.
You don't have to worry about me just because I've been in jail.
Oh, I know plenty of men who've been in jail.
How many of you know busted out?
What were you in for?
Robbery, auto theft, a few things. I like to keep busy. So what do you say? Give me a lift into West Dallas.
The police are looking for you.
They ain't ever gonna find me. By this time tomorrow, I'll be 500 miles away. I just want to see my folks before I go.
Okay.
You and this world will remember.
Are you crazy, busting out of jail?
Now, baby.
No, don't you now, baby. Me, how in God's name did you let Clyde talk you in a fugitive?
It was my idea.
Yours?
Yeah.
Well, how could you go and do this? Here I am praying my heart out. They shorten your sins.
Well, your prayers were answered. This made it real short.
Oh,
shut
up. Oh, God.
You sit down.
Evening, ladies.
Evening,
sir. I'm here about your husband, Marvin, a.k.a. Buck Barron. Heard from him?
Not since he got himself arrested. Don't have no room for a man like that in my life. You find him sitting in McLennan County Jail.
No, you won't.
What?
He should be sitting there, but he ain't.
What?
Your husband and his brother got it in their heads to escape.
What?
If you see him and know anything of his whereabouts, you call the Dallas County Sheriff Hall straight away. You hear it?
Of course.
You have not seen.
Sorry to interrupt your hair, dude.
David, you were fantastic!
I'm having a heart attack, Bob. They're not gonna stop looking.
Remember the attack?
They'll never find me if we go away someplace, maybe New Mexico.
I'll have him in. We're gonna get him.
You're always talking about wanting to go to New Mexico, start fresh.
This wouldn't be going to New Mexico. It would be running from West Dallas. She's got a point.
Well, I mean, him. I hate that real name.
Look, do you want to be like your brother? Hmm? Always running from the law, always looking over your shoulder.
We cannot start fresh like this.
We start fresh when you are free in the eyes of the Lord and saved in the eyes of God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
And spend our whole lives hiding.
Look.
There ain't no way. It is time to light the slate as the good. Gotta serve your sins to live. But you are going back to jail.
How's he talking?
You won't be scared to turn a corner and open your front door. When you're on the side of this, and you ain't nervous all the law. Now pull yourself together because you're gonna pay. But you are going back to jail. Me, Daddy. Stella, you know what it's like having a husband in jail. Tell me how hard it is not to have a call around.
Are you kidding? It's tricky to get the nails done and the time to read a book. Sure, he's watching out of long guns. It's pledging not to pay. They have enough, thank God, those prison walls are much too tall to scale. My darling's not stuck in jail.
I don't want her coming around here no more.
Hey, well, Trish's husband's been in jail 2 years. Without her, man.
Tell him. At first, I really missed him. I thought I would waste away. Then I met this boy from Tucson, and he all shivered away. He had a lot of things that might show left. But didn't I hear a guess to be an accent? And I've now got lots of hair, but I can't. Oh, come on, let's see me.
Someplace with a payroll. Gas station, clothing store. Can't do nothing without cash, and once I got that, I can hightail to another state. Maybe in the Northeast. Cops can't cross state lines, and they ain't looking for me in Ohio. Ohio or New York. After that, I'm a free man. I can do whatever I want. You know what?
What?
You're gonna come with me.
What makes you so sure?
The smile.
Just because I'm smiling does not mean.
I was talking about mine.
Well, I should get going. And you want to see your folks.
Come on. What are you writing?
A poem.
What kind of poem?
Kind that's going to be published.
Wow.
Yeah, you're going to see my face in the movies and my poems in the magazines. Poetry by Bonnie Parker. And a beautiful picture of me to go alongside it like this one. That is what you call a glamour shot.
Now that is the best picture I've ever seen in my whole life.
It's a little old now, but I'ma get a new one. And a nice hat. I look good in hats. I got a hat face.
Read me your poem.
Do you like poetry?
When it's coming out of your mouth.
Okay. Billy rode on a pinto horse. Billy the kid, I mean.
Well, I love Billy the kid.
I know. And he met Clyde Barrett riding in a little gray machine.
You're writing about me? You wrote a poem? Oh, you are so in love, sugar.
Billy said to the bear boy, is this the way you write?
You know, Ford's a damn...
You're gonna interrupt me, everyone. I can't read if you're gonna do that.
I won't
there
say
is it. A rhythm, a flow to these things.
I'm sorry.
I appreciate the enthusiasm.
My lips are sealed.
Billy said to the bearer boy, is this the way you ride? In a car that does its 90 per, machine guns at each side? I only have my pinto horse and my six gun tried and true. I could shoot, but they got me. And someday, they will get you.
What are you writing that for? That's a lousy thing to write.
It's dramatic.
It's stupid.
Don't you call my poetry stupid?
It is when you write stuff like that.
You don't know crap about poetry. I can't
find
my poetry. It's
so far gone from this miserable place. I'm going to just come out. Goddamn, what?
I'm going to be famous. I'm going to be a poet and an actress and a singer.
A singer, huh? Well, come on, let's hear something.
I'm not in the mood.
Oh, come on, Streamer. I want to hear you sing. Unless that's also going to be about me getting shot up. Now, look. You're in a nightclub in that there Atlantic City. Me and Capone are sitting ringside. The crowd's going crazy.
Bonnie, Bonnie, Bonnie.
How about a dance? What do you say? I got some moves that I love to show you. Let's find a spot.
It's me, Mama.
Why didn't you tell me your mama's?
Who are you?
Well, I'm
Mama, this is Clyde Barrett. He's a cousin of my friend Charlene.
Good evening, Mrs.
Why in my house this time of the evening?
Oh, well, I was just...
He was just passing through on his way to Ohio to get a job in printing.
Printing, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Not many men have a job these days.
No, ma'am.
You should consider yourself very lucky.
Well, hey, who plays the you?
My husband and God bless his soul.
Amen. May I?
Go ahead. Where did you learn to play?
Old man taught me when me and my family lived under the viaduct.
You lived in one of those caves?
Yes, ma'am. Pa was a sharecropper over in Henderson County when the land dried up. And after we were evicted, we lived in a tent under the Oak Cliff Viaduct for near 3 years.
Well, Clyde, you may sleep on the sofa.
Why, thank you, Mrs. Parker.
Bonnie, I'll expect you up very shortly.
Yes, Mama.
Almost immediately.
Mama.
Your husband will be home now.
You got a husband?
Baby.
Well, it's something you should tell a fella.
I had a husband. Went to jail about 3 years ago.
Still there?
Nope. Just not interested in being a husband. Is that really what you want to talk about? Right now?
Mm-hmm. Oh, shit! It's the loss! Meet me tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. 145 Oak Grove over in Harris, where someone throws something in the second floor window on the corner.
Ted, what are you doing here?
I was just following some leads on the prison break. Since I was in the neighborhood, I figured I'd stop by, you know, to make sure you and your mom had.
Oh, we're fine. Thanks, Ted.
You know, the last time I was here is when your grandma died.
That was a long time ago.
You know, that was the first time I ever saw a dead body. Now, I mean, she was wearing a lot of makeup and all, but you could still see she was dead.
Maybe you've seen her like that.
I remember how we both hid under your front porch.
Eating buttermilk pie.
Oh, man. You used to love buttermilk pie. And, pineapple upside down cake. And just about any flavor of ice cream.
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah. Anyway, I'll pick you up on Saturday.
Ted?
And, keep the door locked, all right?
All right, Ted.
Most folks will be shocked to learn just how un-Christian you are to bed.
Why, Daddy,
you have to have my view. I'm going to be settled the next 8 months.
I am too. But the time you're away is going to fly by, and I work. The salon's still busy. No matter how bad things get, women always have money for their hair. I mean, Eleanor's kids haven't seen real milk in over a year, but that woman gets her colors done every 2 months.
I love you, lady.
I love you too, Dad. You and God's mother.
It's Clyde.
Martin Alvin Barrett.
You've been using our home as a criminal rendezvous point?
Oh, come on, Lance. It's just Clyde.
Which makes this a criminal rendezvous point. Want him out of here as fast as possible, you hear?
He's my brother.
Yeah, well, that man is the hell in hell.
Hello.
Hey!
You okay?
I'm fine.
Like shit.
Slept in the woods. You see the paper today?
No.
Buck and Clyde on Barrow time. What the hell does that mean?
That means we're on the front page headline right next to Al Capone! Hey! Remember we saw Capone riding through town middle of the afternoon in a white Model T Roadster? It's gonna be us, fuck. Riding the open road in a Model T. Will you ever see a picture of those MGs over in Europe? They got a four-speed gearbox with a top speed of 65 miles per hour! Hey! Ain't no car too smart for me. Got the whole thing figured out. Two-door hardtop Model T.
That you can't drive, I would bet my life on them. I'm the roads to pick the truck, 40 miles in nothing plan.
Ain't nothing better than to ride through town with the throttle down. Watch the old bull jump in. When I drive, I'm in love, I'm alive. And I forget about everything I hate.
If you drive, if you drive.
I think the first thing, we hit someplace with a payroll, gas station, clothing
store.
What is your problem, woman?
Tell me.
Tell me what?
Well, see, I kind of got a plan, too.
Well, let's hear it.
Well, see, I'm going back to, I am going back to prison.
You've gone back to where?
Mm-hmm. Back to prison.
I swear it sounds like
Buck's gonna go back and finish his sentence. And if you had any sense, you would live inside.
What is she talking about?
Well, and society.
And me, you know.
Why both of us? The best thing for me to do is to go back in and finish out my sentence. You know, man, we can go and drive after.
I feel like I'm losing my mind here.
Man, Blanche, we want to start fresh.
No running, no hiding, no secret knots. Maybe you should go back too. How long
going back ain't what I do.
It is the only way to wipe the slate clean.
Oh, you can wipe all you want, Blanche. Ain't never gonna be clean.
It don't make no difference what we do. They've been arresting us since we was kids.
You've been stealing since you was kids.
Even when we didn't. How many times they come by our tent and haul us in for no damn reason? When I worked over at Mason's, they come by, pat me down right in front of customers. Now how's a man supposed to keep a job? It don't make no difference what we do. The laws are gonna keep on coming after us.
Not if you seek forgiveness.
Well, the sheriff don't give a rat's ass about no forgiveness.
Forgiveness from the Lord, Clyde. That is the only thing that will set you free.
I ain't never gonna be set free, Blanche. Freedom's something I gotta steal.
So what's it gonna be, Buck?
I'm going back. Bye. I want to start fresh.
And what are you gonna do when you get out? Come back here? And work doing what? Picking up scrap metal for 3 cents a load? Or maybe with Pa at the gas station, praying somebody rich enough to still own a car stops by. What are you gonna eat, huh? I'm gonna be in control of my life. I'm gonna live my life the way I want, out on the open road. You have yourself a nice time locked up in that cage. Let's go, Shirley.
Maybe your brother has a right idea. Maybe the way
my brother can do what he wants. Clyde Barry ain't set foot in a prison again.
So then maybe we go someplace else. We want to get out of Dallas anyway. You can find a job someplace and work. I want you to be a man, honey, not a thug.
Don't you ever talk to me that way.
Don't you ever raise a hand to me, baby.
My advice to you,
stay away from that man.
Well, don't you look at me like that, Daddy. You know I'm right. If he wants to descend to the depths of hell, he doesn't need to drag anyone else down there with him, not you, not me. But that furnace got trash if you quit last night.
I thought you said it was wrong, Judge.
That was not a judgment. It was an observation.
Even though your presence sounds prayers.
mister. But you know what they say? The Lord giveth, and the Lord taketh away. He's... Bonnie's gonna love that dress. Put it in the bag. Come on. Come on! Oh, hey! You got a gift card? To Bonnie. I can't wait to rip this off of you.
In Worcester, Mass.
I'll go anywhere on this earth with you, baby.
And if that don't pan out, then they got places to rob up there just the same as here.
No more holdups, baby. Hey, I'm gonna start playing. I brought you a picture, baby.
Without him, you think hard, sweet one.
with me tomorrow?
I will.
Blanche.
Eleanor.
Well, I just hate to see you get hurt. That man of yours has been in and out of jail 10 times.
Seven.
No. All I'm saying is chances are
I asked you to pray, Eleanor. Not to judge.
Mac, you can't do that.
Well, I'm sorry.
And someone else. Someone who looked like me.
Yeah, sure.
I really don't see why this is
so. Why are you lying to me, buddy? What is so awful?
I'm not going
to lie to her mom.
I'm in love, Mama. Oh, you and me both know Roy ain't never coming back. I wouldn't want him if he did.
How can we avoid his name alone?
He doesn't live there. He's just staying there a short time.
There's nothing in it.
Bonnie Parker, you're flirting with Poppy?
I'm not flirting.
Don't throw your hair.
I love him, Ma.
Love who?
Who do you love?
Clyde Barrett.
Clyde Barrett. The boy spent the night at our home. You said he was headed up north to a job.
Love him, Mama.
You don't know him when you know it's so good.
Love him, Mama. I know
that Poppy did it. You want to see him.
You always said it. You and Daddy was loving for sure.
Don't have to person comment to your father.
Your daddy was a fine, upstanding citizen. He earned a good living. Father to you and a good husband to me. Do not ever compare some comedy to your dad.
I know my heart. Don't care what people say. All I know is that I never felt like this. And besides, I wouldn't change him if I could. No man's all good. I always knew what I was taking on, but I always felt that I could change his ways. Even if my man will never fall in line, I'm glad he's mine.
Chestnut Barrett, you have been found guilty of 7 counts of robbery over $50, and a sentence to receive 2 years on each count, for a total of 16 years at the Eastern Penitentiary.
Stop! What's this?
My mama doesn't like me smoking.
You got 5 minutes.
My name is gonna make the history books. Too bad I won't be here. In a year or two, I'll be as known as Chicago's Al Capone.
Bye, baby.
See you soon, children. Thanks to you, Bonnie Babe, I can make plans again. I got lots of reasons to keep living.
She's a good girl, a straight A student, she's got a job, it don't make sense.
She's the only one who could have done it.
I know her.
Maybe you don't.
Wedge, look at this, front page.
Bob Barron somehow got a gun, smuggled into his cell, pulled it on the guard, and the man that they set free. He's free, Wedge.
He's a fugitive.
They're never gonna catch him, no one drives like Clyde. Hey.
No need to rush, everybody gets autographs. All right, the words on our epitaphs.
Two living legends, that's what we will be. And that's okay with me. If you place that the old folks will turn their heads, they'll be hollering the doors to Denver.
to steal. And you cannot buy your soul back. God don't make that kind of deed. When your prayers will go unanswered, and the dust is getting worse, when you live near open sewers with just pennies in your purse, that is when the good Lord will become your savior.
Comes by and tries to be a hero.
What?
He had his gun run on me.
What happened,
Clyde? I had no time.
What happened? No.
No. It was him or me, sugar.
I can't say.
Thank you.
in, out, nobody gets hurt. I figure we can rob my first bank next week and pay some out a couple of places. I will keep in touch and we'll find a way to see you on the phones. Brother, Clyde. You know, say what you want about Clyde, but he never forgets family.
Maybe you can ask him to try harder.
Don't you ever want it just a little bit, baby?
Want what?
All the things you can't have.
I have everything I want, Daddy. It pains me that you don't.
I have everything I want too, baby. But there are still things I want. And I'd like to give you everything in the world.
Can you stop, Dad? I don't have room for everything in the world.
I suppose. Good food. Somebody doing your hair.
All right.
Fine, Ben.
I mean it, Daddy.
And they'll ask you, please, baby, buy anything you want. The American dream. Sugar.
I ain't interested in no American dream, Daddy.
I have no idea where Clyde is.
He doesn't communicate with you.
No? Mm-hmm.
Two brothers get arrested together, break out of prison together. It seems to me like you boys are real close. I find it hard to believe you don't keep in touch.
Like I said.
All right. We'll make a couple of weeks in prison between you and
us. No. Clyde Ratz, this is all.
Did he tell you he killed my deputy?
Lord have mercy.
It's Bonnie.
Oh, yes.
I want the letter.
I'll burn him after reading them.
We can lock you up right now.
For what?
Corresponding with a fugitive.
He doesn't write back. He can't arrest a man for receiving mail.
You hear from Clyde Barrett again.
You want the venom.
You tell him I'll not rest until I get him. And I'll go get him. Same as I'm gonna get you to get one of these things.
Go fuck yourself.
No! 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 He is a good man!
He's a piece of shit just like his brother.
I have been worried sick about you.
I'm okay, Mom. I'm okay.
And Bonnie. Said you killed a police officer. I don't know you anymore, do I? Not since you went to that prison.
It was him or me.
It ain't safe for you here. The laws keep coming around.
I don't want to see you.
I don't think that's it.
If I could write to you.
No.
Should be notified.
You're Clive. Clive Barrow and Bonnie Parker, ain't you?
Yes, we are.
Can I get your autograph?
Sure. Where's the... Hey, mister, can I get that?
Two Archie, if you will.
Well, best, Bonnie, and Clyde.
Well, why's your name come first?
Bonnie and Clyde sounds better than Clyde and Bonnie.
Clyde and Bonnie sounds just fine to me.
Bonnie and Clyde rolls off the tongue better. There's a melody to it.
Hey, Archie! Which you think sounds better, Bonnie and Clyde? Or Clyde and Bonnie?
Clyde and Bonnie.
We'll talk about this when we get home. Now, my friend here is going to approach the counter. I would very much like if you would fill her bag with cash.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
Do you not see this gun, mister?
I can't fill the bag with cash because there isn't any.
They're saying the bag is broke.
Not a nickel in the drawers.
You're telling me I'm robbing a bank with no money?
Complaint forms are over there.
You own every piece of land in this county. Everybody's home, everybody's damn farm. How can you have no money?
Well, we meant to sell the farms. No one can afford to buy.
Oh, I should shoot you right now.
Come on, Clyde.
What kind of stupidity?
Come on,
Clyde. I lived in a camp 3 miserable years. The bank took the farms and near everybody I know. No money! In a bank! What the hell is this country coming to? I gotta go to him. He needs me.
I need you. Daddy, I need you.
Clyde's been shot. Katie's in trouble.
Clyde's always in trouble. Clyde's always gonna be in trouble. He is not your responsibility, Clyde.
He's my brother. Maybe I can get him to stop running and come back.
No, it's too late for Clyde.
It's never too late. You taught me that.
Don't you walk out that door!
I gotta go, Blanche!
You're not going because you want to bring Clyde back.
There ain't nothing for me here! Come with me, baby.
Don't be a fool, we belong.
No!
No, I can't do it!
You just get a good firm grip on the bullet, yank it out as hard as you can.
Oh, no, I can't.
Don't even think about it. It's like removing a splinter.
There's a hell of a lot more blood there than a splinter. I can see clear inside your shoulder.
Don't show me that! Close your eyes. Close them.
So...
I'm feeling for a bullet.
Yeah.
You're gonna hide between your fingers.
Uh-huh.
Oh!
Ah! Oh, Jesus! Oh, that was disgusting. Oh. Oh, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Okay.
I'm okay.
I figured we'd be halfway across the country by now.
Well, we're out of West Dallas.
I want to stop running.
We need to keep moving.
I am sick of running.
We need to lay low.
Man driving, I am sick of that car. I want to settle down.
we settle down, I'm dead.
So this is it. This is our life.
Sure.
I should have left you when I had the chance.
We'll be fine as long as we stay here for a while. They're looking for us in Kansas, so we're fine as long as we stay here in Oklahoma. We can find an apartment, something nice. Hey, read me your poem. I love it when you read them.
I'm not in the mood.
Oh, come on, sugar.
You heard them all, and what I'm working on now ain't done.
Well, read me what you got. Read me anything.
I ain't done yet.
I don't care.
Okay. But I ain't done.
I understand.
You've read the story of Jesse James, of how he lived and died. If you're still in need of something to read, here's the story of Bonnie and Clyde. Nothing rhymes with Clyde and Bonnie.
What about... Go ahead.
Bonnie and Clyde are the bear gang, I'm sure you all have read. How they rob and steal. Those who squeal are usually found dying or dead.
Like that there bank teller. Bam, bam, bam!
There's lots of other truths to these write-ups. They're not as ruthless as all that. Their nature is raw. They hate all the law. Stool pigeons, spotters, and rats.
Ooh, you got the lingo, baby. You got the lingo. That is good. Send it to the papers. They'll print it.
Really? You really think they'll print it?
They'll print anything that has to do with us.
Oh, my God. I'm going to be published.
Knew Clyde when he was honest and upright and clean. That bitch has killed four people. And they are printing her poetry like she is Emily frickin' Dickinson. We look like fools. I got a warden, can't keep criminals locked up. And a sheriff who can't catch them when they escape.
God drives like the devil.
Governor Ferguson, you don't fix.
Fairness! Two police officers and two civilians are dead. And public opinion is Bonnie and Clyde are heroes. There is no fairness, Sheriff.
You know what I'm working with here. I got no money, no resources.
We got three deputy sheriffs, two shotguns, for Christ's sake.
And one of them keeps getting damned.
I swear to you, you're on the trail.
I've read the reports. You have no idea where the hell they are.
Three detectives says the cops are looking for us in Louisiana and Missouri. Oh, well, listen to this. Escaped with Bonnie Parker, the ravishing redhead.
It's you, sure.
Ravishing. I like that. It's more than beautiful. It's,
it's you.
I wish there was a picture. I should have pictures to go along with this.
We don't want no pictures, sugar. The job's hard enough.
Seems a shame not to have a nice big picture of me alongside where it says ravishing. Or on the cover. I want my picture on the cover. You only gotta hold up to get my picture on the cover.
We don't want no pictures, baby. When someone sees your face, they're never gonna forget it.
You're just partial.
I lied. I start thinking about my Bonnie.
You wrote a song for me.
For from the minute I wake up.
You are so in love, baby.
And that feeling is the best I've ever had. She is in my shaving mirror. She is in my coffee cup. I must be in love, or else I'm going mad.
This is just my big fun.
You're gonna come interrupting me?
I'm sorry.
I can't sing if you're gonna do
that. I won't say another word.
There's a rhythm, a flow I gotta go in.
I would like to write to Bonnie, tell the girl the way I feel, but I'm better with a car than with a pen. Used to think I'm only happy when I'm sat behind a wheel. Now I don't care.
Anyone follow you?
No, I swear.
No, what the fuck?
Ledge.
Son of a bitch, you came.
Your brother came to talk to you to give yourself up.
Ledge.
I give myself up, Ledge. I get the chair. And as happy as I will make you, I think I'll pass. Come see this place.
Where's your horse? They are fashionable, and they are comfortable in the car. Good earth. Take a grand wage. God's good earth is dried up. It's dead.
you are testing me in ways I cannot understand.
Into the West Texas Armory.
What do they take?
Enough weapons to start a small war, including three branded automatic rifles.
Holy shit! Oh, shit.
Thank you.
They better. You can't tell me you ain't scared.
Shit out of
them.
We start firing, you start shooting from up here.
Okay, baby.
We
We are gonna get out of this.
Guns, you know it's gonna be you or them, and there's no time to think about anything else. You grit your teeth and come down on it, and then it's over and done, and there's no going back. You killed a man. You see him lying there if you have time to wave him off. Life's gone. You took it. And he'll never live and breathe and laugh again. But if he beat you to it, you'd be lying out like that. It gets mixed up. The whole business, them killing you, you killing them. You wonder why you were born, why anybody was born, why God should bother with the whole mess. You okay, sure?
My leg's burning.
You gonna keep moving? You gonna be okay to walk?
I don't think so. Mike's treatment.
They're not tail blanch.
No, he needs to be in the hospital.
We can't go to a hospital.
No, he needs a doctor.
He's beyond a doctor, Blanche.
Then he's your brother, your flesh and blood. Why are you just gonna leave him and die?
You better come with us, Blanche.
No, I'm not gonna leave him.
Go with them, baby.
No.
Started, so.
We can move on from here. Look at all this behind us. You just hang in there, Daddy. You hang in there.
I want you to go back home. Blanche.
No. No, I'm not going to leave you here. We go get you, Will. I'm going to go far away from here. Yeah. Hey, Daddy, don't you remember New Mexico?
Yeah. I do, baby.
Yeah.
I do.
No, but to feel the wrong turn to him. And when you do, his light will shine. And he's looking to.
Thank you.
even his father. Bonnie was involved in a shootout, police officers and jumping all stuff.
Is she okay?
Yeah. We developed a roll of film from a camera. Pictures of her on the road, in the car, in the apartment in Jacqueline, and a few with you. One right here on this porch. You've been seeing her.
She's my baby Ted, of course I see her. We always find a place to meet.
You always know that now. And they're gonna be on the lookout, and the next time they find
me. Does this porch look clean to you?
Mrs. Parker.
No matter what I do, I just can't seem to keep the dust down.
Mrs. Parker, please tell me what Bonnie said to you last time you saw her.
She said, when they kill us, don't let them take me to an undertaking parlor. Bring them home. So she's coming home to me. No, I gotta be with them ready. My baby's coming home. Our folks.
mean if you say it, honey. That's what folks say when the Ma says it, chick. Bringing biscuits and honey.
Come on. Let's go.